Hello everyone. Today I will be talking about a novel type of chromatography, dual flow chromatography, and how it's applied to automated protein and DNA purification. To start, it is important to understand why PhyNexus developed this type of chromatography. PhyNexus is a life science company dedicated to producing tools to increase research and development productivity. The costs of developing the drug and bringing the drug to market are exploding. Costs were estimated to be $800 million in 2003 and were estimated to be $2.4 billion in 2014. Industry-wide needs include a more cost-effective discovery of a drug candidate, faster development of the drug candidate, and better development of the drug candidate. We need to lower the cost of development and improve the effectiveness of the final drug. It turns out there are many areas where dual flow chromatography can improve productivity. If we just take one example, drug development, there are several areas where dual flow chromatography is applied, including lead optimization, process development, protein analytics, and preclinical assays. Each of these areas use different columns and buffers, but can all benefit from dual flow chromatography. Chromatographic concepts and principles are used in dual flow chromatography, but in a novel manner. The chromatography functions with off-the-shelf modified pipette tip columns in a 96-channel pipetting head. The pipette tip columns can be used on any leading robotic liquid handling instrument. In one example presented by Genentech on our technology, a manual process was replaced by our dual flow chromatography process. Their previous workflow would use manual columns to deliver proteins to the genetic analytics group. They needed to analyze more samples than the manual purification process could deliver. Fortunately, the analytical tests to be run on the samples only needed small amounts of protein. This meant that the protein could be grown and purified in plate format. A workflow process was developed using a platform that completely automated purification and all downstream analytical methods, all using a 96-well plate format. Several plates of columns and samples can be loaded into the robotic system at the beginning of the day with continuous operation. The final result was a $4,000 savings in labor costs for every 96 samples purified, and by automating into a plate format, including sample growth, purification, and assays, up to a 19,000-fold increase in productivity was achieved. To describe the technology, we start with the column. The column bed is located at the end of the pipette tip. The bed is contained by a top and bottom screen of woven mesh. The column is available in 200 and 1,000 microliter tip sizes and five different column bed sizes ranging from 5 microliters to 160 microliters. Virtually any type of resin can be packed into the column format. In dual flow chromatography, the sample and mobile phase enter and exit at the column tip. All flow is back and forth flow. This includes sample loading, column washing to remove impurities, and elution and recovery of the desired material, hence the name dual flow. The columns are miniaturized and they must operate in parallel, 96 at a time, and they must operate with automation. The drug protein product must be of high purity, inactive, and not agglomerated. This is very difficult to do for proteins since they denature or agglomerate so easily, especially for very small columns. The final method conditions developed for resins and buffers must be no different than used for classical single column chromatography or for large-scale column manufacturing systems. That way, whatever process is used for research may be scaled for in-depth research and eventually manufacturing. To show how dual flow chromatography operates, we will examine the physical and mechanical properties of the column. How fine is the control of flow of liquids through the column? Next, we will examine the separation chemistry properties. How can we miniaturize while using classical chromatography conditions. Back and forth flow is the key. This video shows the process. This is a 5 microliter bed column. 10 microliters of liquid is deposited into the well. The column is placed in the well and the drop covers the bottom of the column. The pipette piston moves and eventually produces a vacuum high enough so that flow starts through the column. Flow stops when there is no more liquid in the well. The process is repeated several times with several back and forth flow cycles. Finally, with the final expulsion, the liquid drop is deposited back into the well. The volume of the droplet of liquid is essentially the same as when the process is started, 10 microliters. This is shown by this slide, where the starting drop is essentially the same as the final drop. This process shows that small sample volumes can be manipulated with precision and accuracy. The sample proteins are not exposed to a nonpolar frit. Proteins are not harmed. And just to show again, the dual flow process is operated in parallel with up to 96 samples. The liquid flow is identical for each column. The next parameter to consider is the separation chemistry properties for chromatography. Separation selectivity is controlled by isotherm chemistry. Isotherms show the mobile phase chemical conditions at which materials are absorbed to the column media and at which materials are dissolved in solution. We use this information to develop buffers for capture, wash, and recovery of the desired material. This slide shows stylized sharp isotherms for the separation of desired material from impurities. Solvent strength condition A shows the buffer conditions at which a column is loaded. The desired protein drug symbolized by the red segmented line and impurities symbolized by the blue segmented line, are all absorbed onto the column. As the separation method proceeds, the eluent strength is increased to eluent condition B. But the red material, the material of interest, is still completely bound to the resin. Finally, at eluent condition C, the desired material completely desorbs from the resin and can be recovered. So with sharp isotherms, separation methods can be developed, but for this to happen, all column interactions must come to completion. They must come to equilibrium. But sharp isotherms can be difficult to achieve with conventional single-pass small columns, including plates and spin columns. Biomolecules interact slowly with these affinity columns, due to their slow kinetics of capture. The time of interaction of biomolecules with the column may be insufficient and may be difficult to control. The flow is not reproducible. The problem is exacerbated with small columns, including small diameter columns, such as spin columns and plates. Linear velocity of the mobile phase increases as the column diameter decreases, leaving little time for interaction of the sample with the column. This is illustrated by this animation of a conventional single-pass chromatography column. Note the interaction of a sample with the column bead is shown by the interaction groups turning red. For very small columns, the flow is rapid and the interaction of the sample is not complete. This is especially true for the walls of the column where channeling of fluid often occurs. It is difficult for the interaction of the sample with the column to be complete. The separation isotherm is not sharp, and there is likely to be poor yield or impure product produced. But when we switch to dual flow chromatography, channeling does not matter. The kinetics of interaction does not matter. There are multiple chances of interaction, and it becomes impossible for the interaction not to be complete at the end of the process, Even separation beads along the walls of the column where channeling can occur will capture sample. With back and forth flow, it is almost impossible for the interaction of the sample with the column not to be complete. Sharp separation isotherms are possible. With dual flow chromatography on a pipette tip column, the time of interaction is easily controlled. Complete interaction of the analytes with the column can be achieved. Samples brought to all the resin functional groups, there are multiple chances of interaction with sample molecules with the resin functional groups. Interaction time is efficient to drive the equilibrium of sample and column to completion. Since in back and forth flow, column interaction is driven to completion or to equilibrium, separations are independent of flow rate, independent of column diameter, independent on how well the column is packed, independent of the amount of resin in the column, and they're only dependent on the column and mobile phase chemistry. Chromatography is parallel, multivariant, and scalable. This is shown by this next slide where several different columns of protein A was used to capture an IgG. It is interesting to note that the smallest column, the 5 microliter column, takes the longest to come to complete capture. This is because the linear velocity of the fluid is fastest with the smallest diameter column. But within 2 to 3 minutes of back and forth flow, the interaction is complete, the capture is complete, regardless of the bed size. Of course, the shape of these curves will change depending on the protein being loaded or the resin being used. Different proteins have different kinetics of capture. Different resins have different selectivity. Different columns have different flow properties and different channeling. But at the end, they all come to completion with dual flow chromatography. This is an example of this type of chromatography performed in parallel. In this experiment, 96 sets of separation conditions were studied. 8 conditions each of capture, wash, and elution conditions were varied with 4 different antibody proteins. They were captured on a protein A affinity column. Yield and agglomeration were measured. The results show the importance of doing these experiments. The experiment shows that you can achieve high yield, but very poor quality protein. You may also get high quality protein, but very poor yield. Only a very few of the conditions studied gave both high yield and high quality protein. Frankly, not all researchers will perform this study on a new protein or resin because it is so difficult to do. But with this technology, multivariant chromatography is very easy. And this technology has been adapted for all common robotic companies. Virtually any robotic liquid handler is easily turned into a high-throughput 96 in parallel liquid chromatograph. Dual flow makes column scaling predictable. This plot shows recovery of an IgG protein from a 5, 10, 20, 40, 80, 160, and 320 microliter bed column. The recovery is linear to bed size. We have several customers using our columns to develop separation conditions for preparative protein purification and also drug manufacturing. 2 references are shown here. We have used the scaling ability to meet new market trends. One of these is to help researchers perform work with mammalian proteins rather than E. coli, yeast, or insect proteins. Using mammalian proteins is desirable because they are closest to what the human body produces. Historically, it has been very expensive and slow to do research on these proteins. A new technology, transient transfection of plasmids into mammalian proteins, has dramatically reduced costs and time. However, this requires very large amounts of plasmids to be available for the researcher. To scale up plasma prep, a large column is needed. A 20 milliliter pipette tip was available on the market. A 20 milliliter pipette tip was available on the market. We made this into a column to a 20 mil column using a handheld pipette. So we knew we could produce large quantities of plasmids, but no robotic system. With Festo's help, we built our own robotic system. Festo provided the gantry, controllers, firmware, and engineering support. With his support, we were able to get the beta instrument into the market and test it within 1 year. With this support, we were able to get the beta instrument into the market and test it within 1 year. The PhyNexus Autoplasmid MMG robotic instrument is the result. The instrument produces maxi, mega, and giga plasma DNA prep. The instrument produces maxi, mega, and giga plasma DNA preps that are suitable for transient transfection. The plasmid produces of the highest quality needed. That is, they have this instrument will produce plasma preps with yields ranging from 1.5 milligrams to 10 milligrams per sample from a wide range of culture volumes. It is the only robotic system on the market to perform these large-scale sample preps. All other kits are manual. The value of this instrument is in labor savings. Obviously, automation means much less hands-on compared to manual kits currently used. There are huge time savings, especially compared to outsourcing. The researcher has better control of intellectual property. Your plasmids and proteins remain on the company property. There is better continuity of research flow. Protein drugs are designed and tested within days rather than weeks. We believe that this instrument and technology will have a huge impact on improving the quality and speed of research. To summarize, why is dual flow chromatography different? Well, for one thing, there is no effect of slow capture kinetics. It's irrelevant. There is no effect of how well the column is packed. It's irrelevant. What does it allow us to do? We can miniaturize culture and sample in plate format. We can automate. We can run samples in parallel. Purification conditions can be scaled. Scaling is important because conditions developed for process can always be scaled for further research. Why does anybody care? Well, our primary market is for drug development to lower development costs. But this type of technology can be used anywhere where high-throughput chromatography purification is needed. For example, to capture and purify other types of biomolecules.
Why does anybody care?
Enzymes.
Well, our primary market
we
is
have
for
developed
drug development
several
to lower
diagnostic
development costs.
But this
we are
type
branching
of technology
into all these different
can
areas.
Be used anywhere where high-throughput
is available by phone or
visit to discuss any application.
For example,
to
capture and purify other
Thank
types of biomolecules.
React enzymes. We have developed several diagnostic applications. We are branching into all these different areas. PhyNexus is available by phone or visit to discuss any application or workflow needed. Thank you for your attention.